Welcome down to the Hollingbourne Cricket Club. We have our ginger colleague and old Ivanhoe new recruit, Chrissy Cleland. How are you, Chrissy?
Good, mate.
Mate, pretty good. Got the bit of a sunscreen as the mark today. A bit of a cheeky gag for the pale skin. You want a quick application? Just as we get started, mate, do you have any nicknames we don't know about? Anything from the past apart from ginger?
I've got an absolute plethora of nicknames, mate.
Plethora, yeah. Give us your favourite one.
Back home, I'm called Polly.
Polly?
Believe it or not.
Yeah?
After Shaun Pollock.
Yeah?
I'm ginger, in case you haven't noticed.
Not Polly, is it?
All right, you got a big trip to Australia planned, mate. Are you excited for it, obviously? What are you going to miss about the motherland, and what are you looking forward to? Is it the warm Christmas, searing hot sun, another season of cricket with me?
I think the thing that I'll miss the most is the standard of cricket. Obviously, it's going to be a bit poor out there. It's
yeah, if I play, obviously, yeah.
Well said. I'm going to get that dig in early.
Yeah.
In terms of what I'm looking forward to.
Yes.
I don't know. I hear the women are quite sort of amenable out there.
Prawns and Barbies.
It's just what I've heard on the grapevine. You know, I couldn't possibly judge.
Not a problem. Fantastic. What's your favourite sunscreen?
Favourite sunscreen. Anything.
Anything factor 50. Yep. Do you have a particular favourite shade of ginger that you like, or African sunset man?
No,
or
are you not a particular shade that I prefer. I don't like a strawberry blonde though.
No, you don't.
It's just a cop out, isn't it?
Yeah, a little bit.
It's not proper ginger.
Cop out. What's the best ginger joke you've ever heard?
I've not a joke as such, but the best one I ever heard was when I met a girl. She once went to me. First thing that she said to me was, "Is the basement as rusty as the roof?"
and is it?
Yeah.
Rustier.
I like it.
All right. Who's your favourite ginger of all time? I'm a Emma Watson, Ed Sheeran fan myself. What about you?
I'd go to Shaun Pollock.
Shaun Pollock?
Yeah, definitely, yeah. Bit of a role model.
Fantastic. All right, a segment I like to call Name That Teammate. Who's the smartest bloke around?
That's Gutsy.
Gutsy. Yeah. He's a bit too smart for his own good, isn't he? Who's the most annoying?
You. If the cap fits, mate.
who's the boringest bloke around?
That's a tough one. There's a lot of boring blokes in our team.
There is, yeah.
Oi.
Two of them over there.
Yeah, it might be Gutsy, actually.
Yeah, Gutsy.
It might be Gutsy again.
who's the laziest?
Jack Cook.
Cookie.
Sorry, Cookie. Sorry, Cookie. But
mate,
you break my heart. Who's it? I'm up in a bit.
Who's the
funniest?
Have you been, Sean?
Funniest, me.
You? Not looking.
Not on recent evidence, but you know.
No, that's right. Who's the weirdest?
Might be me again.
Might be...
No,
sorry,
mate,
you've just gone with that one.
Dale!
He's not a team, mate.
No, we play Sunday team.
Alright.
Yeah.
Sorry, mate, you're not involved in that. You just stay over there.
Too old, mate.
Yeah, probably Dale.
Dale. He's a strange one, isn't he? Alright, and this field is yet to be named.
Field.
It's a field.
Is it?
Because we field when we play cricket.
Alright.
What would you, if you were to name it, what would you name it?
Well, I've had a bit of time to think about it, and I still haven't been able to come up with anything good.
Yeah.
But I think maybe the Bourne Bowl.
The Bourne Bowl?
Yeah.
That's not bad. I'm going to go with DC Park, because DC can do no wrong. All right, not a problem, Chrissy. Good to have you on, mate.
Well done.
Looking forward to seeing you in Australia.
That's it.